He's gonna blink it. Whoa! Huge black hole. There's a rabbit. SKDDT. They pop the pipe back. They're totally bouncing around. It's doing nothing to DDT now. That's all that life is back. Link getting BK down. All that game body down. Taku. Metamancer pops the Dolman. Link one going down. Right on the ball back. DDT. How are they alive?
Welcome everybody back to It's Ghosted vs. Western Wolves. We have ourselves a bit of a short break where we all just turn our microphones off and forget to turn them back on again. We are here for your quarterfinal game. It's the third one for the Team Dignitas Dota 2 Invitational. It is the French going up against the Americans. It's Ghosted vs. Western Wolves. Let's jump ourselves inside Zik Game, which is where the game will be taking place, obviously, as we just change up our quarterfinals and everything else. Game sets up very, very quickly, so we're good to rock and rumble. And we will get to go through our drafting stage. This time around, I am by my little lonesome. Basically, Fee has to go off. He's got a practice, got a big game coming up after this one. Of course, EG will be going up against DTS in the fourth and final quarterfinal for this evening. Of course, we do have this game. And then do remember at 3 a.m. CET, which is a grand total of 9 hours away, 6 hours away, we will be doing the semi-finals coming from the Razer Dota 2 Cup, which is happening now in Singapore. So I'll be joined for that one. So let's jump ourselves inside the game. As far as our bans coming out so far, Shadow Shaman, we do have Darkseer being banned out. Morphling is also banned out. Respect ban. Invoker as well as AM making it into the ban pool as well. Of course, this means now because Morphling makes it into the first three, now we have ourselves a Chen, we got ourselves a Prophet, and the question is, do Ghosty want to let one or two of those guys through? It'll mean banning out something like a Windrunner or a Venomancer or something along those lines. The choice is theirs for who they want to remove. Of course, Phoenix will love it if they manage to get Chen first. Pickets with Western Wolves, so the choice is theirs. I don't know if they're going to take Chen over or Prophet, however. But Chen is pretty powerful, so it'll depend on the combos. So I'll wait for the guys to select. One last ban. How do you want to do it, Painted Gold? Prophet's going to be the ban, and that's going to let Chen through. And Bucky Mad wasted no time whatsoever picking that up. It means we'll have a Windrunner coming up from the Dire side. And one other hero. They really didn't need to do that, though, because you can bait that out. You could have easily got the Prophet back yourself. All you need to do is just ban one thing. You knew Bucky Mad kind of wasn't going to go for anything other than Chen. It's like Phoenix's favorite hero. It's everything he wants in a hero. And now the Dire's going to have to go with Windrunner plus one. And they've already got Shadow Shaman banned out. Darkseer's been removed, so the big hitters have already been taken out. And they're going to take Tidehunter as well as Venomancer. They'll leave the Windrunner for Bucking Mad to pick up. And he will be quite happy to take that one. It's like a free gift. Fantastic. Why even wait? Why even need to use extra time to select that? So they got a good side lane solo. Great during team fights. Good damage as well. Chen for heal. Chen for push. Chen for aura, Chen for everything you possibly need to send heroes back to base and then just pawn all over again. And the Dire at this point have got good team fight possibilities out from that. They might even just look at Enigma and try and keep their hand hidden for the rest of this. But if they do pick up an Enigma, that means a VS can come up for Western Wolves. And they do still need one ganking support hero for the Western Wolves. And more than likely, they will probably go with a VS. Would be a half-decent aura stack. Not to mention the fact that VS as well as Chen, they're a great ganking combination. So you have those two guys walking around inside of smoke. Instead, no, they're going to go up with Sox's Sand King. He's run it many, many times for that solo mid-roll. Question is, will he be able to do it again? More than likely, yes. At this point, Windrunner's going to be looking for a solo anyway, so they can run that duel on the bottom, as well as running the Chen inside the jungle, unless they want to be a little bit more aggressive and head up towards the top lane. But that'll depend on what the Dire want to pick up next. But they will definitely be banning out Vengeful Spirit in the next couple of bans.
5 seconds remaining.
I do kind of like that voice. That voice just relaxes me at this point. It's been a long day of casting. For those people who haven't been tuning in, we've now been live for over 12 hours. We went live at 7:30 this morning. 7:30 this morning is when we went live. I'm just double check. Yeah, we went live at 8:30 this morning. We went live. So we've been live for over 12 hours, streaming out basically nonstop. There was a 1 hour break in between. But that kind of ended, and then we got back into the whole streaming thing. So it's been a pretty decent day, and it's not going to end just yet. Mirana's going to be the pickup from Gosu. So they do get themselves some nice damage added to it. Moorlock is going to go straight into the ban for Bucky Mad. Really not wasting any time whatsoever. Wants to ensure this draft goes their way. Ghost is also going to be careful. They might want to think about this too, just a Lashrak ban. Either that or Broodmother. We have seen Western Wolves enjoy running that Brood, and that would give them that well, they've already got a side lane solo from Windrunner, so they probably don't need that as well, unless SK is going to go into the roaming, ganking kind of supporting role that SK can do so well. For Force Heidemann, who's now asking, what time does this end? It ends tomorrow night at about maybe midnight. Just letting you know, we are streaming live for that entire time. Tomorrow night at midnight, you will get to have your break. And I will also be having my break at the same point. I'm praying that there will be a shop open at some time at this time. Yeah. Don't know what will be open in Spandau. Anyway, there's that Brood ban from Gosu. So we're thinking the same thing. Enchantress banned out from Bucking Mab, just removing out that neutral option in case they did want to give levels of Tide. It's always a big problem when you see Tide's first pick. It's like, are they actually going to go Tide as a carry? Are they going to give him a lot of farm early on? Not really. You can't really class him as a carry. It's more like a farmed up mid-hero, if that's a possible term. I don't think that really is a really correct term. But yeah, it's a possibility. And Ghost is just thinking about the last one. And more than likely, should be looking at bans. They've already got Venno. They want to remove out the support heroes. Either they take CM or they take VS. At this point, it could go either way. Both, in fact, all three heroes from Western Wolves would love to have a CM. And they're going to ban out the Vengeful Spirit instead. So they remove out that support hero. They don't want that aura stack with the Command Aura. So that's exactly what they're going to do. Remove her out. And that means Radiant will be able to pick up the Crystal Maiden as their fourth hero. Just keeping a little bit secret for what they want as their fifth and final. Do we go a hard carry? Do we even look towards the lines of Lich? That is something Western Wolves have done in the past. We might see a Lich as well as Faceless Void combo. And the Chen as well as Windrun will buy them time for that. And really, the Dire, they don't have a big pushing lineup. And that can be problematic for them. If there is a bit of a turtle kind of way of doing it for Western Wolves, just defend their tier 1 towers, Chen can do that. And when they want to push, yeah, you can push then. But Ghosts didn't have some, they don't really have raw pushing power. Thank you very much to Nilsor, who says there's one store open called the Beer Store. I walked past a bottle O on the way home, and I can tell you right now, it is shut at 2 a.m. in the morning, which is sometimes what time I leave the studio. It's great. It's great. In the meantime, Beastmaster. So, Stock will get, who's he going to play? Funzie would kind of want one of these guys as well. But Beastmaster comes up, so looking for that mid lane hero. Or it's either that they can run him on the bottom. Not quite sure with what they're going to do with an SK. I think Ghost are in the same situation. Do they want to use Beastmaster? We have seen Beastmaster play support, but only Poppy did that. And that was done yesterday.
10 seconds.
So it might be an option right now. Was that yesterday or was that today? No, that was today. Wow, time flies when you're having 12-hour casting sessions. So they're going to keep on going. The Dire, who do you want? You've already got your supports. You need yourself either a mid-solo if you want to go up against the Beastmaster. Might even think about Nightstalker at this point. Wouldn't be a bad option. Wouldn't be the best option in the world because Beastmaster would love him. Either that or they could look towards Slaana. That would make life a living hell for the SK and a good way to bring down Beastmaster nice and quickly. But Dire need to make a choice sometime soon. And also, if they want to risk that Enigma, the VS is banned out, so if they do want to run a jungler and give that extra farm towards the Tide, they can do so. But the question is, do they really want to try that?
5 seconds remaining. Who calls the Crystal Maiden?
Crystal Maiden's going to be it.
Radiant.
So probably the support hero the Radiant we're looking at still to pick up that Beastmaster and then couple it with the CM. But not going to be the case. CM taken from Gosu, so they got a lot of mana up their sleeves for this, but that's also an extra support hero, which means Tide will require to get himself a lot of farm. And Bucky Mad's going to make the choice right now. Do we try and win this in late game, or do we try and face them? Do we try and face them in the mid game? And that's a big option for them. They could just go safe and pick up a Faceless Void and just go, hey, we're going to take you to the very, very bitter end. What are you going to do about it, Sunny Jim? And Mirana, CM, Venomance, as well as Tide. They got some decent team fight as well, some decent burst damage to come through when they want to push down a tower. But as far as raw pushing power, that is something they do lack. Killing off creep waves is different to killing off towers nice and fast. Unless they pick up like a Lashrak as their last one, at which point, hell freaking yeah, Gosu are going to win team fights as well as push towers. But that's the choice for Bucky Mad. What does he want to do? Well done, Nilsaw. Well done. Oh, man. 25 seconds. Bucky Mad's got to make a choice. I do also realize that Melk was mocking me the other night for calling him, because it is 7 King Mad, but it's actually meant to be Bucky Mad. So there's going to be a big tanky kind of guy. Nakes will be in the lineup. It'll be very, very difficult to kill him. Not to mention, you've also got Nakes inside a Crow. Keep your eyes open for that. He'll love to jump himself out. It's going to make it very difficult for Morana to escape. Even with that leap, you throw an open wounds on her. You get any form of stun. And Morana is basically doomed. Crystal Maiden will basically be maybe 2-3 hits. And then he'll be down as well. So at this point, I'm kind of liking the build here of Bucky Mad's lineup. They got good stun, they got good team fight, and the best thing you can do when you get a melee hero smacking you in the face, you grab yourself a Razor. Something electric. Hold off that life steals. Now everyone gets to select their heroes. A lot of mana dependent heroes for Gosu, but they've also got some decent mid-game potential through the Morana as well as Razor. But it's all very dependent on how much farm that next will as Beastmaster receive. And how much damage is done to the Tier 1 towers very early on. If there's a lot of damage done to the towers, then, well, we could be looking along the lines of Gosu trying to farm and doing it riskily, and then they get caught out. And there's a lot of heroes of theirs which can die very, very quickly. So everyone is now in, so we'll check out who's going to be playing what. Universe on Tidehunter, Bedizzle. Bedizzle will be taking the Venomancer. Bulba will be taking the role as the semi-carry of Razor. Korok will be taking the role as Morana, and Painted Gold is our final Crystal Maiden. Bucky Mad will be taking the SK. Sock taking the role of Lifestealer. Leaf will also be in this lineup because he is the German addition to the French lineup, taking the role as Beastmaster. Phoenix doing his normal thing as Chen. Nothing like a big jungle hero and a guy who really knows how to play him. And then Funzi will be doing the final role, and that is my beloved Ranger, my lovely Windrunner. She's inside the mix now. I love how someone just asked in the chat, where did Doombringer disappear to? Doombringer hasn't been picked since the International, man. Actually, that's not entirely true. He was picked for a couple of weeks after, and then he disappeared. Nicely done. Shout out to Vlad if he's currently tuning in. Nice. Nice. All right, so pause is going to end in just a couple of moments' time. The pause was done by Gosu, so they needed a moment. I'm not quite sure what for. Oh, sec washroom. Really? You called a washroom? Okay, I'll go with that. Whatever tickles your fancy, what floats your boat, scrubs you clean. I don't know. Find yourself a saying out of all of that somewhere. But the pings go off. I don't know what that's been for. It's like, hey, yeah, you know, here, this is where you pull creeps. It's a little camp here. Yeah, you pull them up this way. Pull them on that lovely 20-second mark. Actually, generally 23 is the better. 22, depending on the creeps. I'll just follow the pings around the map. Ping here. Ooh. All right, there we go. Ghost is ready. It's Bediz. Thank you very much to the guy in the chat. He's Bediz. Bediz. Bedizzle. I want to call him Bedizzle. Bedizzle is just so awesome. I'm not going to say it during a team fight, though. Bediz. So 128. Canadians, what a closet. Is that what you're meant to be saying? Bluefield? Canadians will call it washroom. I don't know if that's what you're trying to say. Or what a closet. It's called a toilet, mate. It's called a toilet. A bathroom. A bathroom. Alright, so there we go. Unpause now happens. Well done to Crystal Maiden. Just unpausing the game. Nothing like a bit of a smiley face to come out from the French. Good to see the high spirit about this. There were a couple of debates over pings on the server. We are playing on a US East server, which means some players have a pretty nice ping. Some players do not. I don't need to bring that up. Nothing like the players just stalling it up. We should have ourselves like an interlude music. I need like interlude music where it's like do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. That'll be nice. That's always, you ever had like that elevator music? It's always good. Nothing like keeping ourselves active on an evening. Nice. Extra couple of seconds taken to check that. All right, so now we're good to go. And we'll roll out. Let's check out our lanes. So it looks like we might, well, they've done this before looking for kills, but it looks like Kurok will be heading towards the top lane if they're going to throw Bulba there. Bulba just missed buying and then just selling his items back again. Rana is heading down towards the bottom lane. Going to combine it up with, who even knows right now? It might just be this tri-lane of support heroes and give the extra farm towards the Venomancer. Up towards the top lane, SK and Windrunner are up here right now, but SK, yeah, he's just here for the wards, not for much more. And Chen's also up here, so maybe we might see a tri-lane on the top. And that'll give Sok that middle lane by himself. And also give Leaf that bottom lane by himself. Not gonna be the easiest lane for him. But it's an easier lane than going on the top lane as the Beastmaster up against a tri-lane. And Bulba is gonna rotate out. But he is already on the way out as well. So maybe Mirana and CM, we're going to see a dual lane coming out from Gosu. As Tide as well as Venno head up. Looks like Bulba will be taking that solo mid roll. And we'll have a dual lane set up from its Gosu. Funzi's on the run back up towards the top lane, but bucking Mad Phoenix as well as Funzi. Illusion. It's a lot of stun, there's a lot of damage depending on what creep waves they manage to pull off. And Universe is already on the way up. And mid lane heroes, Nakes, up against CM and Bulba. So Mirana is left her own device on the bottom lane, which she'll be very happy about. Mirana versus Beastmaster. Mirana should have a great time. And B-Diz is getting caught out here. Bucky Mad will go for the stun. All they want to do is just damage him down a little bit. They would prefer to get a body block on right now. And Windrunner's already gone first level on Windrun. She's kind of going to be kicking herself right now that she didn't have that one level on the power shot. Or Shackle would have bought them enough time. And Bulba, first level on Static Link. It was something the Fear was commenting on the other night, just how powerful that ability is. So we see Bulba going at first level. Makes it very difficult for Sok to get any form of last hit in, but then again, he's only lost zero damage. So what he's got to do is the second that pops off from Bulba, just walk yourself away. But there's 20 mana for control over a lane. It's kind of very similar to what Ancient Apparition does with his cold feet. Nova manages to pop off. B-Diz is on the run. Phoenix does have that Centaur. He's going to look for the stun. The question is, will he get it? Nope. B-Diz moving himself around the tree. Now the Centaur comes back in again. Misses on the stun. There's a lot of damage being done. And Bulba, he will be Burrow Strike through. But Venomancer gets the last blood, the first blood, with just that ticker off the poison. And Razor will take the second one. Bulba having a great time. 2-0 now. And the heals will come up. And Western Wall's not being happy with this, both SK as well as Chen going down. It's always great when you try and go aggressive in the jungle, but you've got to push on the tower. It's got to be a purpose for doing the aggressive jungle. Sok just hangs back a little bit further, Bulba. Gets his boot set out to him. Nothing like a kill to increase the item progression. And there's Kurok still going up against Leaf. Not the easiest thing for him to do, but with that ball, Kurok is going to be a little bit more, maybe defensive is the best word. Really does slow you down. Funzi looks like he's just managing to escape on the top lane. Venomancer teaming up again. As now we see Bucky Maswell's Phoenix looking to gank up on that middle lane, and they can do it too. Bulba has already extended a long, long way through. All the damage has been taken out from Nakes. There's the Satter Blast, and the open wounds will be enough to help out and kill Bulba. One last blast will go.
Punishment for your sins.
But Chen gets the kill there on Razor, so the first hit back here from Western Wolves. Down towards the bottom lane, Beastmaster. Looking to hold the line for the moment, as Bucky Matt heading up towards the top lane. Painted Gold's trying to get himself up there. Funzie's looking for the... he's only be able to do the body block, but tied under being here is not going to make this easy. CM lands a stun. Bucky Mag could have gone for a dual stun just then, but decides not to. There goes the first stun. As the Sandstorm, we'll get the last hit. Sand King finishes off the CM. Phoenix is here as well. Funzie trying to retreat back out. Phoenix can pull Funzie out if he needs to, and he probably should do so right now. But no, healing stab will pop. And then the Galvin from B-Diz really send Funzie back before he ticks over. Either that or deny him. And there we go, Phoenix gonna send him back now. They get the kill. Venomancer being killed by the tower, so the money is split. And Funzie will heal up and then TP himself back up towards that top lane. And now towards the middle lane. Volver and Panic Gold really holding socks off that line. It's not going to help for their for his farm, and as you see the gold grab, just come back up again with the last couple of kills from Gosu. Finding some openings. Level 1 kills are always good, but they're not worth a lot of money. Early levels, yes, but money, not really. Not unless you get the first blood, at which point you're laughing.
Double damage.
Bucky Man searching for a kill, he's going to find B-Diz. And Painted Gold did the right thing, grab the rune and go the other way around. And Bucky Mad will find him. CM will land one hip. Flying out downhill. Gale will hit as well. Satter blocking the path and also letting off one bit of a blast. It's going to be the death of the Satter. DDCM does way too much damage. Not to mention that Frost Cone timing is just so damn long. As Bulba tries to hold up the middle lane. So I kind of wants to go in there, but he realizes how much damage he's going to take if he does do so. It's that double damage rune. Not to mention the amount of damage which he doesn't deal. And the main reason because of that is this guy right here, two levels on the static link. This is the newest version too. So the storage time of that damage is so much longer. Causes so many issues for heroes like Nax. And now Bulba. Nax is almost trying to bait him to go on him. That way he can open wound. They really want to get a kill on CM more. She's the easier and faster one to bring down. Bulba is not a certainty. There goes the open wounds. SK will follow through with a Burrow Strike. There we go. Centaur wants to get in, but it's a good stun there on the Centaur, but it's not going to be enough. Surge will fly out. Stock thinking about diving back past the tower. As Bucky Mag goes in, Viz in the Sandstorm. But both heroes now heading back to base. And they will heal up and then go out again and do it all over again. As Leaf continues to go on the farm, how are we looking at that bottom lane? 30 for Kurok. And Leaf doing 24 for 1. Not looking too shabby as far as farm goes. Considering I really expected Moran to win that lane a lot more. And then towards the middle lane, Bulba versus Sock. Sock at 19 for 9 and Bulba 19 for 10. So really nothing between those two guys. And then up towards the top lane, Funzie is the Windrunner. 14 for 5. Up against Universe, who is 19 for 6. You wouldn't really say there's a lot, and the Goldcraft will agree with me. There's very little gold difference now in the bottom lane. Beastmaster gets the kill on Morana. Painted Gold to see about going in there. He kills off the Hawk of Beastmaster and then hastes himself away. Sock with the rage. 63 damage has just been stolen. I think he'll give life with that amount of damage which has been taken from him. Negative 103. So much damage and taken in so little time. And the damage is not even given back yet. Now Sock wants to go in. Starts to right click on Bulba. Burrow Strike as well. Now the damage is given back. So Bulba lets off one bit of a plasma field. And then thinking about Bucky Mad, who gets himself stunned. Goes inside the Sandstorm and Chen will pull him back to base. He has no mana pop off anything else though. So he will just go back to base. In the meantime, Funzie. Getting some much needed farm up on the top lane. Is under attack. Trying to find some form of advantage in the tier 1 tower of him is what it's going to be. Bucky Mad's heading up towards the top lane. He's almost close to that epicenter. And once he hits that, then Ghost is going to be very, very careful. They know the epicenter could come at any moment. That's going to cause them to be a little bit more defensive. And Nate's going to love that. More space for him to move around. And the push now going to come on the tier 2 tower, tier 1 tower on the bottom lane. Open Wooze to start it off. They will not be diving this, however. It was all about the harassment and trying to bait out that leap. It's the second time Mirana wants to do exactly what she's doing, come in. There was a creep wave with this. They can dive back past that tower and very easily get that Beastmaster roar off and get the kill. Because there will be no leap. There is already low mana. 3 seconds, and they're going to come in through the rear, and they're going to spot CM. Making a move, so now they realize two heroes in the bottom lane. This is not as easy as originally Western Wolves thought, but they're going to go for the Crystal Maiden. So Beastmaster, less off the roll. One last right click from Sock will do the job. Now Open Wounds, TP's going to come in from the Tidehunter. He is level 6, so if he wants to pop the Ravage, he will do so. The Rage is already up from Sock, who will then turn around and try and fight here on Universe. Leaf, he doesn't have enough life to live through this. There's too many heroes up here. Sock wants to right click down Universe, but he's having his life stuck from him. Jumps inside the ball, then jumps back out again. Still had 42 attack damage taken. Surge is not going to be enough to get a kill. Starfall, he needs to leap and do the combo. But now Chen is going to come in. Not level 6 just yet. Bucky Mad, not quite sure what he wanted to achieve there. We forced a Burrow Strike up to the walls, the high ground. Arrow's going to fly as well. Nice time for the Sandstorm. We'll pull him back out of it. Maybe not. Surge, big damage. Mirana with the Starfall and the plasma Surge out from Bulba. Sorry, Plasma Field. I always call it a Surge, and everybody is just like, oh Darkseer. So confusing. Nakes has done his treads. Down towards the bottom lane, Sock. Trying to keep up with that farm. What we got from Beastmaster? He's on his way to that Vanguard. And up towards top Funzy. Arcane Boots as well as Ring of Basilius. Cost him all his money, but it's going to give him a lot of mana to use. Question is it going to be enough? P. Diz is looking for a way to initiate on him. And Nace is just on the walk back out. Not really want to be part about this. Well, sorry, my fault as well. I realised the co-commentator wasn't updated because there is no co-commentator. Thank you very much to Alan JB, who's watching in. Arrow's going to fly Beastmaster. Just manages to avoid it. If he didn't, he'd be dead right now. The creep wave would have been nuked down and CM would have continued the stun. Which means we would have seen Leaf force to tank up the tower. Now the Gush from Universe is really thinking about going on Sock. And very, very wisely thinks against it. Universe, not a man with a lot of mana, but those mana boosts definitely going to help out. And towards the top, Venom and CM. Having a scout around for some blood. I don't know if they're going to be able to achieve it, though. Funzy and Bucky Mad being very, very defensive as far as their heroes go. Just farming up the very outside camps of the Dire Jungle. And by doing so, just being a little bit more safe. In the meantime, how are we looking for Bulba? Still trying to finish off those treads. Decent farm, 38 for 15. Being almost the same as Nakes. 43 for 2, however. Beastmaster is the one who almost takes the lead. In fact, the lead does go to Mirana. Already has the ring treads. I'm looking for a little bit more. That Starfall is just so hard to stop push. He just keeps on pushing with that. Not to mention, if you set up your crit wave nicely, deal off the early damage. Starfall will drop guarantee yourself with that burst damage from the Starfall. You get the last hits. Very, very nice and easy way to farm. Beastmaster's trying to hang out. TP's coming towards bottom lane. I think Ty was really thinking about going that, but he just throws one Gush out in Sock. Buys, goes through some time. Get that farm up on Mirana. They really, really need that. With the farm on Mirana and the farm on Bulba, they're looking very, very good for their late game. What have we got flying out? We've got Gloves of Haze, Magic Wand Recipes. Or one singular. Beastmaster looking at this middle lane right now. Probably wants to try and roar, but it's very, very difficult to roar on a Mirana. Mainly because of her leap. Such great distance makes it impossible for the roar to maintain the target lock. Dias Courier just standing ballsily on the front lines. Magic wand recipe in hand. So Mirana just needs a moment. Not quite sure what's wrong. I'm gonna take this moment to have a drink. I don't know if you know, but casting for this amount of time does make you a little bit tired. And we've still got one big game to get through tonight. Talking all by yourself as well also does make you pretty tired. The amount of oxygen you take in is kind of ridiculous. Nothing like energy, man. Nothing like energy. So in towards the middle lane, Beastmaster trying to get towards that hood. Getting pretty close as well, only 100 and a bit gold away. And Pipe will follow pretty shortly after that. And then the pushing power can really come out from Western Wolves. It's a big thing for Western Wolves. They get these items up at the right times. It's a very mathematical way Western Wolves play. It's the reason why when that draft was going through, they didn't really waste too much time. The only time they really stopped to think about things is when they saw Gosu's lineup and were like, is that actually going to work against our lineup? And when they decided, yeah, that's going to work, they just know what they're going to go with. So you've already got Chen trying to get up towards that mech. And he won't come out of the jungle until he achieves that. So when mech is up, and when the tide... Beastmaster has finished up the pipe. Then they'll look to push on the tier 1 towers. And towards the middle, Mirana trying to hold the ground. Just from the high ground as well, 6-4. Both teams not really want to be too aggressive. They realize at this point it's a lot better for them to control their farm, control their own jungles, than do something stupid, which will lose them either the game or just a couple of lives and force them to fight back even harder. So how are we even looking for the gold? The Radiant, and this is what you gotta fear. When you got a jungler like Chen, when you've got a lot of farm coming in from the Western Wolves jungle, not to mention the last hits coming in from the waves, you've really gotta be careful about this gold difference. 2,500 gold is the advantage. Meanwhile, on the top lane, Bulba trying to go with Bucking Mad. It's a good epicenter. Sand King has managed to kill off the Crystal Maiden with that as well. She was sitting right in the middle of that. And Bucking Mad will fall back. Power Shot will fly through, damaging down Bulba. It's a big Ravage that will finish the job here on the Windrunner. And Bucking Mad has used a Stick Charge, but he needs to Burrow Strike himself out right now. And actually, he's a little bit short. Arrow's going to fly in and ensure the kill. Tidehunter pinned in between a rock and a hard place.
Dire's structures are fortified.
That makes it 7-6 now on the bottom lane. V-Diz forced back. This is the power of pushing Chen with the Centaur. Very difficult to stop him. And more importantly, Nax gets the last hit. So Ethan now, well, he's going to go Armlet. He's basically got it as well. Towards the top lane, Funzi. It's a little bit too late to spot the TP. We just realized that nobody's there. Might have saw the after effects of the TP on the ground. Funzi continues to want to push. Problem is, though, tier 1 tower's down, so it's a long way to push through. And they got to look towards the middle if they want to try and claim another tower. And that's why we see Kurok go back past the tier 1 tower in the mid. Trying to hold the line, but with those towers going down, still 4k gold, the advantage of Western Wolves. This is the way Western Wolves like to play. It's a slow, steady increase in control. Be it over the map, be it over anything. Sock trying to initiate on Universe, very, very tanky. It's still got those stick charges up his sleeve too. Or wand, I should say. It's not a normal stick. Funzi now spots Bulber up on the top lane. Does he have that hood? Got one in Vitality.
Invisibility.
Windrunner's got a 4-staff, well, on the way to it. It's a staff of wizardry, and I'm not going to say that's going to be a Dagon. You just say Beastmaster's got a headdress inside his inventory. So completing half of the item in a bit. There's the rest of it. He just needs the recipe as well. So a lot of it's on the courier already. Venomancer Ward Wall is already up. Level 3 wards, not as strong as they could be, but level 3 wards are still pretty damn strong. Very difficult to get through. For Sir Elephant Barn, I'm guessing that is your name. If you want to find the brackets for this competition, as well as everything we're covering this weekend, you can find it over at joinedota.com in the news articles. The question for you, the answer for you, I should say. Bottom lane, Ravage going off a universal close range arrow on Phoenix, unable to get Hand of the God off in time. Kind of probably wanted to, but also kind of realized he needed to save it. CM dropping down the Nova. Kurok now in a little bit over his head. There goes the Burrow Strike, combining it with Nakes. Now look for a little bit more. I doubt they're going to get it. The Gale hits there from B-Diz, which means Bucky Mad does not want to dive back past that tower. Beastmaster just walks straight up the ball, but this is real confidence from him. Now the push comes in the bottom lane. Straight into the tier 2 towers. Bucky Mad wants it. I don't know if he's going to claim it, though. Trying to give some mana back, and that means there is a Cyclone available if they want it. Which, if they're going to go for this tower and be serious about it, they've got to get that up right now. So in the meantime, Gosu is back at the main base. Or up on the top lane, stranded. He can TP, but sure, but that's a long way to go, and that's a lot of time to give towards that top lane Beastmaster. That'll let him get that farm and finish up that pipe, which is almost done anyway. That gold graph just still capping a little bit at 4k. The XP, however, is not. It just keeps going up. Has hit 4k itself. But it will just keep rising and rising and rising. Now looking in towards the middle lane, power shot flies through. Bucky Mad with that sandstorm, just trying to help push that creep wave a little bit faster towards that tier 1 tower in the mid. It's the last one standing, and while Painted Gold is still here, he's going to be really careful. Extra TP is going to come in through the rear. Power shot flies through and spots Bulba, dealing the initial damage. Chen's creep gets the last hit. There's also a siege creep helping out with that. But the last hit does go to Western Wall, so the money is not denied.
Double damage.
So interesting watching a Nakes versus Mirana lane. Mirana's gonna hate this. She's gonna love even more once she gets that recipe up. Gets that Yasha completed. Venomancer and CM desperately try and hold on towards this middle lane. And they realize now they're forced back to the tier 2 tower in the mid. Razor is now also on the move up. Nothing but farm. Vanguard up on him. Deciding Hood was not the way to go. Maker still 600 gold away on the Venomancer. I want to go for Mirana. She's just going pure damage. Which doesn't leave many. In fact, it leaves no one. CM is gonna, it's not going to have any money. And down towards the bottom lane, you go look through the Western Wolves lineup. So Sock has 2k gold, armlets, treads. Bucky Mad walking around with 975 gold. He's going to be looking for Arcane Boots. Mecha's already up for Phoenix. And he's got another Ring of Basilis as well as a ward flying in. I know those auras do not stack. Now the push onto the tier 2 tower. Should be able to do this pretty easily. Fortification going to buy some time for the Radiant. And there's the extra TP in. Realizing that something is not quite right. Bucky Mad does come in. He'll look for a good epicenter. It's probably not going to be able to claim as they just spot CM walking around and back in again. And now up to the lane on the top. Which means both Nakes as well as Chen do fall back. I realize it's a very, very risky area. I love the little clip. It's not even a clip clop, it's a thud thud. No, that's not who I wanted. I want this guy. Damn it, he's fighting. That's not going to help me. It's a little thud of his paws. So cute. Oh, he's so cute. Invis rune now for Bucky Mab. Do we have sentries? We've got one hawk from the Radiant, and we got one observer ward from the Dire, so no sentries. They won't know what's coming if he wants to pop that. Or if he did, no, he left it up on the top lane. Probably thinking about giving it to someone with a bottle charge. And there's the drums. All about the movement speed. He does in the meantime. Getting those levels up, 4 on the wards. Meanwhile, back on the bottom lane, Sock. Doing what he can to catch up to that Assault Cuirass, either that or Majolana. I would really prefer Majolana from him. Good pushing damage, good extra damage. Either that or try and get to a BKB, but judging by the Hyperstone, it should be a Majolana. There's another pause coming out here from Beastmaster. Have to double check and make sure what is wrong with the Western Wolves, guys. The ping's going out. They're looking for Kurok. I highly doubt they're going to be able to chase him down. But with a double Alpha Wolf on the bottom lane as well as a Satyr, they should be able to bring down this tier 2 tower with basically ease. And let's go to going all in defense, which they can do. Tai's got his ultimate, Venomance's got his ultimate, Storm has his ultimate, Mirana has her ultimate. So there's a lot of options. And they're already smoked up, ready to go. They've established, they've basically said what they want, and that's that to defend their bottom tier 2 tower. But 8-7, how are we looking at gold? Just below 5,000, XP's kind of leveled off as well. So the individual CS, which I'm a little bit more interested in, 116, 106. The Bulber as well as Kurok, I'm hearing open wounds. Leap away. And Kurok decides to turn around, try and fight this one. Now they're going to realize four heroes and Ghost has got extra ones TPing in. Bucky Mad hiding inside the trees, avoids the arrow. He really wants to do an epicenter burrow strike now, but he's got himself caught. Hand of God's going to pop off. Raise the first one to go. Starfall's going to go. Bucky Mad gets inside the sandstorm. That's all he can really do. Burrow strikes himself out of it. So it's a nice play there from Western Wolves. They've got the tank ability to live through that. So now they're thinking about the tier 2 tower. It cost them a Ravage. Cost them 3 ultimates on the Ghosu game, on the Ghosu side. It's Ghosu. Tower is under attack. But on Western Wolves, Chen and Beastmaster, sure, their ultimates are down. But Escape. His ultimate is up. Arrow's going to fly. Long, long stun there on Sock. So 5 seconds is what they've got. And Western Wolves rotated towards the middle lane. Tier 2 tower is what they're looking at. Shut off that farming area of Ghosts who do not let Razor out of the base. And when you're ready to push in hard, push in fast, and push in with support. Here goes the Tier 2 tower, fortifications up. They're going to try and hold him off. There goes the Hawk just scouting out around the rear. Plasma Field just destroys as much of the creep wave as possible. Arrow flies out, praying for a lucky hit. It's not going to be the case though. And Shackle latches Kurok to a tree. Which means he is there long enough to take a little bit of damage, and then the trees are completely demolished there by Beastmaster. Hurling out the axes, mainly for the creep wave, but also for anybody who is thinking about the fact they can hide in there. Which is funny enough, because that's exactly where Western Wolves want to be. So now Western Wolves want to push out the middle lane. Tier 2 tower is gone. And they'll rotate up towards the top lane. That's the way Western Wolves play. It's a little bit more secure, it's a little bit safer. But it can get the job done if they have the right early game. At this point, you're going to say with that graph, yeah, they had the right early game. Their middle game was actually stronger. But they rotate up towards the top lane. Double creep wave for them to kill up here. And in the meantime, Ghosu might be possibly looking for a smoke gank. We've got mech up. Do we have a smoke? Yeah, there's the smoke. So they're going to look inside the Radiant Jungle. The one thing they didn't realize is the fact that Radiant have now pitched a tent up in the creep camps of the Dire side. And they're not. They're going to go straight in for Roshan. Ballsy play here from Ghosu. Get Negus the Immortal. That's what they need for the next team fight, to be able to live and give it to the Razor. Either that or Mirana. Mirana does deal a crap load of extra damage. But that'll require to drop something extra. Where Razor? What do we got from Razor? At this point, he has the empty slot. So tier 2 tower for Roshan. Still 200 gold for either side. The only difference is the Aegis Immortal is now with Ghosu, and they're going to force TP up towards the top lane. Western Wolves are going to enter. Venomance is the first one to try and defend. Are we missing TPs or something? I think we are. CM is now on the run. Yeah, she doesn't have a TP. Another TP is now going to come towards the front lines. Plasma Field pops off from Ghosu. Pipe is also up. Beastmaster lets off the roar, trying to hold Bulber in place for just a moment. Venomancer ultimate manages hit there on 3 of the heroes. But because of the pipe, and only affects one of them. It was just out of range of the effects of the pipe. But Ghosu successfully defend their top lane. Or is it just a bait? I think it's just a bait. Open wounds now on Bulber. Mirana pops off for ultimate. Everyone can go in. Viz 4 starving away. Bucky Mad as well as Hand of God. There goes the Shackle, holding Kurok in place. And now Bucky Mad wants to go in again. Epicenter starting to charge up. Needs to get a little bit closer. He's too far away from the rest of Ghosu. Even with that sentry. They knew exactly where everything was. Burrow striking again. Shackle manages to hold Universe in place. He's already used his Ravage. Good axe. It's flying through. Pain of Gold almost goes down. The runner definitely has. And now they still want to keep on going. Universe on very low life, but so is Lee. Actually pulling him back his chin. Shackle holding Universe as well as Bulbul together. Nice and close. Sock wants out. It's going to cost some amazing, just Rage and TP. And built BKB for the next. Or I should say Lifestealer.
Invisibility.
$3,500 gold for Windrunner. We're looking for that Sheepstick as early as she can get it. Either that, or she can't do that, get a Yules. Does the same job. Just a little bit differently. But with the Sheepstick, you can actually attack them. With the Yules, just send them up in the air. Or yourself, depending on what you want to do. Razor. Yasha's up for him, so Mana Star's not going to be too far off. And that's not really going to help you. Looking for Tide. He's almost completed up the hood. Unless that's the rest to beat. No, there's the pipe. Sorry, it was pipe I meant the first time around. So Pipe of Insight is now up for its Gosu. What else have we got? We got Urn Charges. We got Stick Charges. We got Bottle Charges. We got TP Charges. There's our final person, which is the Venomancer, who has a Gem and Mech. So they got good heal, they've got Pipe, and Gosu have all the essential core items up now. And Ty just trying to get whatever farmer levels he can. He's got Ravage at level 2, but he also realizes there's another 17 seconds before that is up and doesn't want to get caught out like he did last time. So the mana boots pop off. Bucky Mad now has a Blink Dagger. Gotta be really cautious of where he wants to initiate on Funzies now on the run up. 3,900 gold. And they will push towards these barracks. And now we're the Desolator for the Windrunner. Even more damage. They just want to rip through that armor of both Razor as well as Tide. And that's the best way to do it. Desolator is a very, very strong weapon. In the meantime, Ghost is trying to make the most of the time in their own neutrals, but Universe a little bit too far up. There's a Hasted Nakes. Open Wounds coming up. The Beastmaster Roar will be there as well. Shackle doesn't manage to latch. Power Shot flies through. Axis might do the job. And Axis, well, no, the mech is there from Gosu Beaters. And Ty just wants to go straight in. He was like, yeah, you know what, man? I'm with my teammate. We're fine. We're cool. It's great. Don't worry about anything. And now the push towards the top lane. Tier 2 tower's already gone. Tier 3 tower is also actually gone. And Venomancer starts up the Ward of Walls. The Wall of Wards. Yeah. Brain is really struggling to function right now. Razor straight in there. SK's gonna Burrow Strike in. Venomancer will pop off the ultimate. So Universe living his life right now. Trying to make the most of all these ultimates. Hand of God as well as the old heal coming out from Chen. Really trying to stop Mirana from just right-clicking down all his support heroes. And this will be the death of Mirana. Starfall will pop and they cannot catch up right now. And there's not enough mana. And also SK just in range of the gem. Triple kill for Razor. And Ghost are looking pretty good, going to force Western Wolves back. And this is the main reason why Western Wolves didn't want to really push in. They kind of realized, if you push in, we're dealing with a Tidehunter, we're dealing with a Mirana, we're dealing with a Razor. That's a lot to deal with, plus the Venomancer wards. And Venomancer will get done in the middle lane. Ghost is looking very, very nice at this point. Now look at a Tier 1 tower at least. Maybe even a Tier 2, I doubt they're going to have time to do so though. And there's the fortification. Buy some time for its go-to. And one last right click from CM does the job. Up towards the top lane, SK's now up here. He'll be looking for a kill right now if he can land the stun. He would if he had the Blink Dagger up, but the Starfall managed to knock his Blink Dagger onto cooldown. His Mana Style is now finished for Razor. Not really a surprise, we did see those blades up on her a while ago. Vanguard into Manta. We've also got that Ring of Aquilia. Looking pretty nice. TP's coming towards the top lane. A little bit of a delayed one, but Funzie is now up here. It's a problem when you've got so many heroes in one point.
Invisible.
All right, coming up towards the top lane, Invis Rune now for Beastmaster. Going to spot off the Tidehunters. They know he's there. And just sending his boar up first. Searching around for the Gosu players. They know they want to push in through the top. It's the best place for Western Wolves to go. No tier 3 tower they have to fight on. There's a barracks which is just open for them. If they bring that down, they're looking pretty good. And considering they now have the Mana Style up, might be an option. Sorry, normally Mana Style. Bulbul's got the Mana Style up. Sok wants to just lead the way in. He's got the Assault Cuirass. Sada takes the damage for the arrow. More than fair enough. But Gosu just holding their line on the top. We have four. Momentum is probably balanced in the middle lane, but it's leaning slightly towards the Dire. On the bottom. Sorry, mid lane, it looks balanced. Gosu trying to hold onto their line. They can do so very, very easily. It's the reason why we now see the TP coming out. Windrun heading down towards the bottom lane. Look at that, the Deso damage that can pop out. Just so easy. Just eat straight through the armor. Trying to time these last hits so Funzy gets some more money. Tyranny in the meantime. Wait a minute, Tyranny. What the hell? Universe. Who am I seeing? I'm seeing AL. Maybe this drink does have some weird side effects. I keep myself awake.
Thrice blessed.
Now Kurok. Enough farm for him. Pro team's really not wanting to initiate. We've got like we've got 23 kills in the space of almost 33 minutes. And a lot of it's just been like, hey, team fight, we got a couple of kills here and there. But both teams wanting to be very, very defensive. Counter warning now up from Chen. So they're thinking about Roshan, but Roshan's not back alive again. I think that might be also what both teams are waiting for. Get that Aegis the Immortal up. Or wait for Razor to actually time out that Aegis the Immortal. And Gosu might want to think about doing something with this. Where's the smoke? Where's the sentries? Where's anything they want to? Because the Aegis the Immortal is not something you just want to waste. If it just times out, it's like, well, we got 200 gold. What was the point of it? Well, intimidation? That could basically be it. And we're watching with the time. Western Wolves catching back up on the farm. They just control more of the map. That's why we see the Assault Cuirass up on Sok. He must have some decent farm right now. And, well, it is pretty decent. 153, 152 for Funzy on the Windrunner. And 123 for the Beastmaster. Leading the way, though, Bulba with 184. Has had 3 deaths to his name, but got 5 kills to it as well. And then 163 for Kurok. And 103 for Universe. So items are coming up, and that's why we have the pipe. That's why we have the plate mail. Looks like it's going to be pipe as well as Shiva's Guard for Universe. And Chen has that Vladimir's Offering. It's all about the push. It's all about the aura. And Deso is now going to be combined with Noga Club. So looking for a BKB for the Windrunner. Just really sick of these stuns. Open wounds, blink up, and it's going to be a Beastmaster. Raw Kurok's already used the leap, and the slow will start to wear off. Runner popping up the ultimate. CM's going to come in, putting the stun now on Beastmaster. They turn around, and great arrow. The timing there from Leaf for the TP was not perfectly right. And that's what we need to wake us up here. They even dropped down a sentry ward just to ensure they would not be able to escape. And even Bucky Mag getting caught out in the middle lane. Bulba coming in. And Funzy pushing out the bottom lane. He's been there for a while. We saw him before when we were talking about the Ogerax. Just pushing that creep wave towards that tier 3 tower just to make Gosu think twice about going for it. That's why Nace is up here on the tier 1 tower. See, I'm just not really quite sure about this. He doesn't know who else is here. The Radiant Ward is watching his movement. It's going to watch Bulba heading up towards the top lane. Because that SK destroys off the middle creep wave. And there comes the TP. So Funzy is here, Shackle, manages to latch. Both CM as well as Tide together, but Tide, wow, that Kraken shell. Do you really want to try and bring him down? It is almost next to impossible. Mane still wants to give it a shot. So does SK. A blink and Epi. He can use a full combo with the mana pool that he's got. And they're going to look for retreating Gosu heroes. They're really going to find it because they're not really retreating. They're just rotating in towards the middle lane where Chen is currently getting some farm. Some much needed farm on Chen's point of view. Level 13, so you do have that level 2 Hand of God. It's a big heal to have come to you during a time of need. Power shot will fly through, try and kill off this creep wave, and Roshan's now back up again. So Gosu might have their moment. It's going to be the point when they try and just strangle this back. But then again, we're going to see Western Wolves. They're going to go in. They already have smoke. They're not being revealed off. And they're thinking somebody is in here. And there goes the pings. The ball is having a bit of a run. As Western Wolves are going to find B-Diz in the middle lane. Or in fact, B-Diz finds them. Not quite sure of the rest of the support there, but while the Tier 2 tower is not there, Western Wolves can feel pretty confident of going for that. The problem they've got right now is the fact that Kurok is pushing out the bottom lane. As Kurok pushes out the bottom lane, they can't go for Roshan. They can't just take that timeout to do that. They need to find some form of kill. But while Universe is also on the front lines, if he gets that pipe off, they'll release even a Ravage. That's really going to start to hurt Western Wolves. And I think Western Wolves, they lose a Tier 1 tower on the bottom lane to Kurok, who now buys up a Demon Edge. Could be careful for him. He's got no money for a buyback. And now maybe they finally look for a kill on the bottom, but Moran just TPs out. They don't know this. It's just going to be Stock heading down. They're going, two illusions, dealing very minimal damage. Basically means nothing is a real thing. Trying to bring down that siege creep. Not to mention, one, it's worth a crap load of money. And we can go two, it's damaging his tower. So two very, very good reasons to get rid of that. Heading in towards Roshan's pit again, CM. Looking to throw down a couple of wards and does do so. One up on the high ground, they spot that as well. The Western Wolves going in. Goes through, know this now, and so Tide, now is your moment, man. Got to get that Ravage of the Sentry. Roshan's now down to half life, and Western Wolves just fall back and counter ward out at the same time. So Gosu realizes this is not the time to go in. And he realizes that Roshan's on very low life, so if they want to finish him off, they can do so. Arrow still flies out. So it's just Gosu prodding. Gosu having a little blink up from Beastmaster. He was hoping to find somebody just hanging up here on the high ground. It's not going to be the case in this instance. He's hoping to even find more because, oh, hello, Mirana Ultimate. This could be big, but they've got to know that counter ward is up. If they walk past this, this could be a big blow, and they will spot them inside the Mirana Ultimate and then going inside the base. And there is too many wards up. Now the counter warding is going back the other way. And Ghost is like, we're going to run in here. Oh, crap, they're not here. This is not what we planned. Beastmaster having a run after Bulba. At least push him out of this fight for the moment. As Tide hangs on the side, Beastmaster sends his boar in. Keeping Roshan company is all about having your own pets. As Kurok tries to farm up. Now Leaf deciding to go. This is the moment. Arrow's going to fly through. It's a long stun there on the Beastmaster. Tide's going to look for the Ravage. He's in a good position to do it right now too until he got shackled on Epicenter. Big one on Gosu. The Ravage will still pop off. Epicenter now pipe pops off as well as Mech. Hand of God. Beastmaster losing too much life. Bulba head in place right next to Roshan. It's going to be a huge amount of damage even from CM's Alderman. Lyastilla is trying to retreat. The Western Wolves are in over the head. Funzy doing what damage he can do, but it is not going to be enough. Lyastilla gets out. Kurok comes back in again. And this will be the death of Roshan. The Aegis will more than likely go to Mirana, dropping his TP scroll. And with the Starfall, he'll finish up his MKB. Roshan has fallen to the dark. And then can leap himself away, or does he? Ooh. Okay. Sell that stick. There's a double jabble. Wants to ensure he has that TP scroll to get up towards the top lane. And the courier's got to get all the way back to base before he can send it back out again. Universe trying to hold up his own end of the farm. Probably thinking that Shiva's guard's not far off, and he isn't really. That's always a nice item for a Tidehunter. Shiva's guard doesn't really cost you too much. You can already see it. In fact, let me just bring it up for you. So Shiva's guard, Mystic Staff, as well as 600 Shiva's guard recipe. Sweet. It's next to nothing. All he really needs is the extra 700 gold, and he's got it. So Tide's going to be very, very happy with that. The only downside is he won't have buyback at that point, but for him, I think Shiva's guard's going to be more important to get it up during the fight. Get that aura working for everybody. So just need a moment. Sokka's just like, what? What's going on, man? Let's get into a rhythm. My rhythm was working. We'll check out our gold graph. Slowly coming back down again, that 12,000 gold advantage, and then we just see it going back down again to 2,000 gold. And even the XP graph is just hugely going the way of the Dire. Not looking fantastic when you look at the Western Wolves lineup, but we're checking out golden experience per minute, mainly on the key heroes, and one of the key heroes is Bulbur as the Razor. 380 gold per minute, 484 XP. Funnily enough, he's getting outdone by Mirana. Mirana with 503, 387. So it's a little bit ahead, and that's why we see the MKB Manta style having the Aegis up, and we're 40 minutes in. It's not the biggest items of all items of Alakazam. Can't really say Mirana's had the best farm of her life, but they're still not too bad. You check out the items of every single person too. Bucky Mad looks like he's trying to get towards that BKB. Also looking the same for Funzie. Highly, he's going Aghanim's now. Yeah, he's got the Mithril Hammer already up there. How much money does he have? 1,000 gold. So packs a punch with every single hit, and if he gets that BKB up, nothing's really going to stop the focus fire. And if he wants to use that, well, you really should, considering he's turning himself into this big damage dealer. It's not a bad option to do it. You got Deso firing out the rate of focus fire. Let's see, damage reduction 30%. But 20 seconds. Oh, very, very fast attacking. Sock in the meantime, looks like he's trying to get up towards an MKB as well. Already having that pure damage from the Demon's Edge, combining it with the Armlet as well as the Assault Cuirass. Bucky Mad, he's trying to reach that BKB as fast as he can. As Beastmaster with drums as well as Pipe and Blink. Really everything both teams need to push out, they've got it. Well, it's just going to require a bigger push from Gosu. Gosu are really on the back foot right now. Even though this advantage is going their way, and the gold advantage is now zero gold. There is really nothing in these two teams. A slight spike up towards Western Wolves. But as Gosu are down to their tier 3 towers, or, well, apart from that one on the top lane, that doesn't exist anymore. But if they want to push back, they've got a tier 1 tower on the top, and then another couple of tier 2s. Their advantage in that way is that it's worth a crap load of money. So you bring those down, that's 4k gold, which they've still got to catch up. The rest of their catch-up, they've done the old-fashioned way. So that gold grab is going to drop down pretty, well, steeply. Funds in the meantime is going to spot Universe out. Power shotting through. While that double damage is on him, Funzie's going to feel a little bit more confident about going there. Throwing down some extra wards, just keeping tabs on that top rune. So in the meantime, Leaf heading down towards that bottom lane. And then up towards the top, Funzie and Phoenix. They really kind of want to engage right now, but they're not quite sure who is inside the Dire Jungle. Their vision from there is basically gone. It's rather more defensive. Roar, Beastmaster lets off the roar. Bucky Man is here. He's going to get a double burrow, but doesn't go in towards the Epi. Kind of feared the extra stun. And will run himself away. Will it be fast enough though? Burrow strikes off cooldown in 2 seconds. He can go on to the lower levels. And there goes the Burrow strike. Sandstorm as well. He pops up for just a moment, but is unable to run away. The gem on the Venomance revealed him out straight away, so there was no stalling in the last right clicking of that. And SK does not want to buy back. In fact, SK cannot buy back. Goes to have an opening. One hero down, but then again, Sock is going to bait them. He's going to try and push against Kurok on the bottom lane, and he can do that too, popping up the Rage. Tier 2 tower in the middle lane. Do Goes who want to try and make a trade? While Phoenix as well as Funzie push out the top lane, both going to TP in towards the middle. Leaf is here, Axes will fly out, a lot of damage towards the creep wave. Shiva's guard does pop, and there's a frontline TP, and they are just going to go on the illusion. That's not what they want to open wound and kill. Mana style illusion blast the dust. Whoa! The mana pops everywhere. Wah! In the meantime, Mirana gets to farm up on the bottom lane, push it back out again. And Gosu, as I said, like, they want to try and push, but you now lost your tier 2 tower in the middle lane. They've got an opening to get through to a tier 3 tower, but that's still a long way to push on in. When you've still got another tier 2 on the top and the middle lane, which means the barracks are not open for attack. And while that's the case, it makes it very, very difficult for the Americans. A lot of Funzie's items. TP scroll now coming up, Desolator. Black King bar 4 staff. In my mind, Windrunner can always bring a game back, but she needs a Daedalus. Get that extra crit up. And just slice through them with a Deso. Heading down towards the bottom lane, Bucky Mab. He just cannot finish that BKB. Double Jabble's flying out. So looks like Nags has finished up his MKB. It's a lot of money to spend for Sock. He's going to be really careful with this. And some good damage and some fast damage. But if he dies, that's a big, big opening for Gosu to push him. It's a long time for him on the sidelines as well. But it's also important for him to deal off that damage. They realize that too. Razor tired, a lot of them will take a lot, and with that MKB, in fact, that's actually going to be the next item for Funzy. It's got to be Butterfly now up on Razor. There's only one way to bring down Bulber, and that's with an MKB. They've got to cancel out evasion. They've got to attack fast, they've got to attack hard. I'm Bucky Mad, still trying to farm up. Western Wolves trying to do the same. Are we even looking at goal difference? 2,000 in favor of Gosu. The XP just starting to level up. It's going to come down to the next couple of fights. Really, the best thing it's going to come down to is who gets caught out. As you saw then, when one player gets caught out, then all of a sudden you're just getting that tier 2 tower down, which you've always been hoping for, but you never found really an opening to do so. Well, how long is it going to be? Oh, hello. Eagle Song, and that's going to be flying out to him right now, too. So Korok going to go Butterfly. Really not quite sure about this, considering the Monkey King bars are already... Well, one is already built for Western Wolves, which cancels out that evasion. It does give you the extra speed as well as damage, but... It also limits you a little bit, considering half of the items are 1,800 gold worth of the item, in fact. It's just not going to work for you. Sentry wards on the ground, it's not exactly where CM wants to leave it. Probably wants to walk close up to somebody she can smoke, just gonna smoke herself. And the Hawk, I don't know if he managed to spot that. No, he didn't. Oh, hello. Arrow's flying out, but I don't think Korok's gonna be looking for anything. Top lane, once he's trying to defend this tier 1 tower. Finally Gosu have decided, you know what, this tier 1 tower is an abomination. 47 minutes in, and Western Wolves still hold a tier 1 tower. Stun's going off on the Chen creeps. And this will be the death of the creeps. Can't do really much about that. But that means there's going to be no tornado, there's going to be no trap. But in saying that, now the TP is going to be forced back to the main base. Bucky Man is waiting. Everybody's coming back. And that's going to let Funzy defend this top lane. And they did need to fall back. Western Wolves, they played the bait game. Push out the middle, push out the bottom. If Gosu want to take the top, make it hurt for them. Illusion. Well, the damage will keep on flying out. What do we got? We're even trying to see a BKB off a Beastmaster. Vlad's mech, Arcanes, 1,500 gold for Chen. That's more than likely it's going to remain on him, and that's going to be buyback gold. Funzy getting ever closer towards that Demon Edge. And then the 3k gold after that point, but he'll like that. Kurok's already going to have a little bit of trouble. In fact, maybe Kurok leaves himself away. Doesn't want to get right-clicked at all from that. But Funzy with the power shot, he can almost right-click these guys down one hit at a time. As Roshan, no, he's not back yet. In fact, now just watch Funzy. One hit, two hit, three hit, four hit, whatever you want, man. Power shot's through. That's a little bit, a little bit behind. Invis for the CM. They already knew that was completely done. They're going to find out Bucky Mad, but there's no support here, so CM's just having a bit of a search around, finding out who is where. Razor leaves his illusions to push out that bottom lane. The real one's here in the middle. In fact, he's going to pop off the surge for one creep kill. What? I should say plasma field. Funzy, does he buy it? I really want to know if Funzy's going to buy this right now. Is it going to be Demon Edge? Yes, it is. So he is going to go with the MKB. It's a lot of damage to fly out from him. It's a lot of damage to go straight through Bulber as well, remove that armor. And the evasion won't help him as well. Agassi Maul is now reclaimed and Roshan's back up again. So this is their time. And it's a big Roshan. Agus as well as Cheese. That's what Gosu was able to pick up. So the stuns have started off, just popping off that the spell immunity of Roshan. Come off cooldown in a couple of moments' time, but that is the death of Roshan. Roshan has fallen to the Cheese is taken by Razor, Aegis is taken by Mirana. And Gosu will now get to push down the middle for the GG. That's exactly what they must do. The call is coming for the defense of the top tower, but that's not really their important thing. They have the pressure. They have the control. They might lose top barracks, but if they can take out the middle, the pushing power of Gosu, oh, actually, no, it's probably pretty level. They just want to try and get this kill on Funzy. They're not going to get it. The field pops out from Bulba, and they'll take out the top lane. But the bottom lane's being pushed out from Bucky Mab. Western Wolves just really keeping pressure on everywhere. The CM four-starves herself down to try and take out the Windrunner, who then pops BKB. I don't think that was intentional. It really cannot be intentional. Gosu were not chasing. There was no sign of them chasing it as well. And in the meantime, Bucky Mad attacks on the tier 3 tower. Unless it's a TP back right now, it's not going to be enough. It's going to be a double TP and then a blink away. He can Burrow Strike as well, and Bucky Mad just adds the pressure. Double TP force back, which means this push in the top lane now ends from Gosu. And Western Wolves keep the game going of cat and mouse. Pipe and Blink Dagger. There's still no BKB up. And Beastmaster may not even buy it. It'd be good for him to have it, but oh, Axe is going to fly. Reveal his position. Venomancer is here. He goes the high ground. And Beastmaster has got Blink Gate, but he's got to stop taking damage before that's the case. Nova's going to hit. They need to keep this attack happening before it. No, there's the Blink. Bulba's on the run after him. It's a lot of movement speed. The unstable current, not to mention the extra agility he's got. And Chen's going to send him back. Fierce will also TP himself back to home. There is no stun. So a nice pullback. Be really careful, but there's Kurok now going on Bucky Mad. Leap flies through. Starfall will fall as well, but Sock is here, and they're going to turn themselves around. Open wounds, Bucky Mad. He chains off the Burrow Strike. It might be enough. Sandstorm up as well. Kurok's on the run, and Nakes cannot get close enough. Is there another open wounds? 2 seconds. 1 second. Open wounds will now pop. Blink up. Bucky Mad gets the kill. Aegis is popped, and then the TP instantly back out again. They do not know what support is there. Funzy, what are you doing, Saint Jim? Actually, he'd probably do this himself. The Nova flies out. Funzy might turn, try and fight this. No, he should not. Get yourself out of there. Tries to lens the shackle. BKB now going to pop on the run. Support is there from Chen. But Chen now can himself stump. Beastmaster lets off the roar. Might turn, look for the nuke. Not going to be enough. Venomancer pops the ultimate, but still not enough to kill off the Phoenix. The mech charge. He still has that hand of God if he needs it. Bucky Mad setting up with the epi. But he needs to go in. Finally, he goes in. But it's late. The pipe already pops off. Chen takes the fall. Windrunner doing whatever damage he can from the rear. Wow, SK. That's a good two, maybe three pulses of that epicenter, which were not inflicted on Gosu. It was just too far away. He stalled himself before he went in. Now SK buys back in the game, but there's still no ultimate. But he can't stop this creep wave from pushing in, which is a big creep wave. It's a dual siege creep in. Axis will fly. Power Shot can take care of the rest. Sandstorm already up from Bucky Mad. A good shackle. Power Shot flies through, but you can right-click more damage than you can that Power Shot. Forced up away. Ravage will pop a fund. He's out of range. He's going to look for another shackle if he can latch, and he will be able to. Universe losing a lot of life, and that's that Death Zone just eating through his armor. Now Bulba's also going to be careful, even though he has sucked a lot of damage at 112 of that. Stick charges almost enough to kill, keep Sock alive. It's not going to be enough. Bucky Mad Burrow strikes through. Goes in Sandstorm. Wants out. Realize that Plasma Field's going to kill him, which it does do so. Double kill now for Bulba. Lewis rolled up. Fighting on the tier 4 towers. Forced back again. He does go down. Now the Deso going to go straight. Shackle again from Windrunner. Power shotting through. There's going to be enough time. 4 Euros down for Gosu. They did not claim a barracks, but they do claim a tier 4 tower in the bottom, or maybe they will claim a barracks. Kurok is hitting it. Kurok's going to get it, but he goes out. He avoids the shackle. Then he turns around. Leap away. Beastmaster. He doesn't have a roar, but he will get himself in front. Marana pops off the ultimate. The invis is there. They need those axes to fly. They do not know where he is. Now they do find him. Is there a gem? Is there something? There is got to be something. Axe has already flown out. There's no dust. 19 HP. Blink up. They finish the job. 5 heroes down. Melee barracks taken by Gosu on the bottom lane. A huge victory for them, but the time for Western Wolves, how much have they got? Can they push through? No creep wavers over the other side of the river, bar that top one, but that's not really pushed fast enough. 73 seconds, but Mirana has buyback. Razor also has buyback. Razor also unable to get that cheese off during the fight, most surprisingly. Had stick charges as well as cheese, it would have been very difficult to kill him. Bucky Man, I don't think he meant to be there. And there goes the Mirana buyback. Western Wolves are just trying to bait it out. Kind of scared of this. They've got all their ultimates up. Ravage is down. And that might be their opening. They might be thinking that as well. Bucky Mad. Currently smoked up. And, well, There we go, Blink in, nice to pop out of Leaf, and they're gonna go. Cubist Guard goes as well, Tired, still no Ravage, Epicenter has gone off. Burrow Strike, still not enough to kill off Universe. That goes after really helping out. B-Diz is on the run, Arrow's gonna fly, managed to avoid a Bucking Mass, a long stun, forcing him away, trying to keep him out of range here of Gozu. This will be his death, but maybe not. Burrow Strike's in, goes for the Sandstorm, and it might be enough for Bulba, but Bulba pops off the cheese, it's a low of life, but Funzy is just sitting on the side. CM gonna drop the ultimate, Universe will go down as well. Funzy needs to get himself out of that. Low, low life, Venomance for ultimate, not making life easy. Phoenix is also getting on the run. Ravage will pop. Nakes needs to get out, but he's not going to. A lot of kills coming out from Gozu and the retreat going out from Funzy. So low life, but cannot go critical with that Venomance for ultimate. And Leaf is also on the run. 2200 gold for him, so he has that buyback. At this point, it's just defend any towers they can. Top lane, it's pushing nicely as well. If Gozu want to push this next, does he have a buyback? Yes, he does, only just. Chen also has a buyback. SK also has a buyback, but this is a bait from Gozu. This isn't an attempt at GG. Fortification is not up just yet. That top lane is going to push through, and that will take out the barracks, and the buybacks are going to come right now. Unless they're on cooldown, that could also be an option. It's the only option for the reason why they're letting this middle barracks go. So now they're double down, and Gozu are going to go for the GG. Pushing on through tier 4 towers. 56 minutes it's taken to get to this point. And Leaf wants to get himself out there. He has the roar. He wants to go for something. If they can hold this off, they will get a counter racks on that top lane. But it's enough to hold it off. Or is it? They're just right clicking on this tower. Pipe is up as well. Focus on the main barracks. What they want. Beastmaster roar. Stopping Mirana. Mirana keeps in getting a little bit closer. A lot of damage being taken. Leaf doing what he can. BKB is there. Bucking Mag comes in as well with it. Well, he used his Epi, but it wasn't enough with the pipe being up. Funzy doing what he can. Four staff away. Beat is on the run. Funzy just go down. This is GG. Triple kill for the Razor. Leaf is forced back. Fierce on the run. GG, well played. Just come out. 56 minutes and we finally have a climactic ending. And that is going to be the fortress. The top barracks has been taken. But what matters is the ancient fortress. Ultra kill is how Bulba will end the game. And Gozu will get to advance into the next round. Who will they face up against? DDS against EG will be coming up next here. It is for the Dignitas Dota 2 Invitational. Of course, big thanks to Alienware for sponsoring this tournament as well. Guys, we're going to be back in a moment. Do not go away. Last game here of the Dignitas Cup. Then we're going to have ourselves a couple of hours break. Then back at 3 a.m. I'm so going to sleep before that time. So stick around. Last game of the night, but not the last game of the day. We'll be back soon.